G'day folks, Rod from My Water Filter back again. And what we're gonna do today is have a look at the annual cartridge replacement for any of the RO 4000 systems. Doesn't matter if it's just the plain one with no alkalizers on the top or any of the three varieties with alkalizer cartridges on the top. Inside, they're all the same. Annually, we normally change two cartridges. We change a sediment cartridge in position one and we change a cartridge that's carbon and it's in position two and four. And we keep one and we dispose of one and we rotate them. So I just wanna go through that with you now, just so that you're aware of how it works, okay? So nice little water filter, probably about $90 a year for the cartridges to be replaced in this system. And it's a pretty simple situation. Two clips either side, off with the top. And when you lay it over, we're gonna be working inside. So you'll see the gauge up the top here. It's got a red clip on it. So I just pull the red clip off and then we're gonna press in the collar. And once we've pressed in that collar, we'll then be able to pull out the white hose, okay? Now if you don't press the collar in properly, you'll never pull the white hose out. So you press the collars in and then that white hose will pull out, okay? So I'm just gonna put this one off to the side for a minute. And basically what it leaves us with now is just a normal RO 4000 water filter. Okay, lift him up there so you can have a bit of a look. But on the inside, all of the range of RO 4000s are all the same. Okay, basically we'll have a look on the end here. This is the diverter coming from the kitchen sink and the water flows in the end here and it flows in. And might be a little hard for you to see from there, but basically it connects onto a white pipe, goes around the membrane, and the white pipe comes over here onto this side, okay? This first cartridge is the sediment cartridge. Here's our new one that we're gonna renew in a moment, and that sediment cartridge gets replaced once a year. Once the water goes through that sediment cartridge, takes all the lumps and bumps and dirt out the water, as you can see, here's a little pipe here, it then comes up to this carbon cartridge, chlorine, chemicals, okay? Take it out of the water to protect the membrane and remove it from the water. Here we've got a carbon cartridge, and that's what we're gonna replace here. Once the chemical and chlorine's out the water, the pipe goes around, and the water feeds into the end of the membrane. You can see it on this end, the water goes around through the end of the membrane. The water's gonna flow through the membrane. Now these membranes are good for about 3 to 6 years, depends on water quality, always depends on water quality, but they are a good lasting RO membrane and we shouldn't have to worry about those at this stage of time. Water goes through to the end. Once it goes through the membrane is what splits the water, okay? So 1 liter down the drain and that's gonna come out of this black hose, okay? The black hose is the waste and we don't drink the contaminated black hose water. So the membrane splits the water, black hose down the drain, and then this pipe here is the good quality pure water. It's going through the last carbon cartridge, which is the same as the cartridge in position two. Both these cartridges are exactly the same, and we're going to utilize this second cartridge. Once the water flows through the carbon cartridge, goes down to this bottom here, it goes out, you drink it, or it goes through the alkalizer and you drink it. So these two cartridges on top are exactly the same and we've only ordered one replacement. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna use the cartridge in position four and we're gonna put it into position two because it's never seen any chemical or contamination because it's after the membrane. So the water comes in and gets filtered through the second carbon, through the membrane, and then this last carbon cartridge just polishes up the water. So we use it for 1 year in position four. Then we pull it out, we put it into position two to fill it up with chemical for the next year before we dispose of it. And then we'll put a new one here into position four. So I'll show you how it's done. The first situation, I guess, is most of the new cartridges nowadays are gonna come with these white plugs in them, okay? You can't connect a pipe onto a white plug. This plug is just to protect and to keep dirt out of the water, all right? So once again, we depress the collar, we hold the collar in, and that plug will just pull out very, very easily, all right? That is exactly the same process that we follow for this whole system. All these hoses are the same. You push them in, they won't pull out. You push and hold the collar in, the hose pulls straight out, okay? So we'll start with this sediment cartridge down here in position one, okay? So obviously it's on the bottom there, so it's not, got some cartridges on top, but just calm down and take your time, and it's very easy to remove these cartridges. So the red clips will just pull off, okay? So we'll start here in position one, and we're just gonna pull off the red clip. Once you've pulled the red clips off, we'll leave them off until we're finished, and we'll put them all on together. So position one, the water's coming from inside, basically from the diverter into the system, and this is its first point of call. We push the collar in, we pull out the pipe, all right? It's as simple as that. Spin it around this end here, off with our red clip, press in the collar, we pull out our red pipe, okay? This cartridge is coming out. There's your sediment cartridge, she's all over, it's done. What you'll often find, as you can see, we just got a connection on this end ready for the pipe, but on this end, it's had an extra elbow installed on it, and that's so that you can get the hoses in and out. Same thing, press on the red collar, okay, hold it in, and that collar will come straight out. I'm gonna put that collar straight into our new cartridge so it's ready to go. This is the old one, direction of flow. This is a new one, direction of flow. We just wanna make sure that we've got them right and the water's flowing the right way, okay? Okay, basically back in, direction of flow, flowing from right to left, and then it's gonna go through here. So we've got it in the right position. Clip him back into place, spin him around so that the connections are up the top. You can get your pipe, push it in the hose hole, push it in, make sure it goes in properly. They do go in 1.5 centimeters. Same on this end here. Got our white pipe through here. We're gonna put it in. Once again, I'm gonna push him in 1.5 centimeters. That's it. Don't be scared to give it a wriggle. Make sure it's pushed right in. Once you've put this together, it'll never stop for a year. It'll be all done and sealed up. And there we go. That one there is our sediment cartridge. It's now connected and it's good to go. We'll put the red clips on later before we finish, okay? Just for now, we'll just keep rolling along and get things organized. Now, as we discussed, that's sediment cartridge one. Water flows over into the second carbon. This cartridge is taking carbon, this carbon cartridge is taking chlorine and chemical out the water. This has got to go. She's old and it's got to go. So the best thing, just get a texter, put a cross on it. We don't need it anymore. We don't want to get it muddled up. We're not keeping it, okay? But we are keeping this good one over here. So what I'd probably do is you can put a 2 on that one, you can put a 4 on that one, just so you know where they're going, and you're good to go. So what we're gonna do is we're on to cartridge number 2, so we'll always work through it. Cartridge 1, cartridge 2, then cartridge 4, so we don't get anything muddled up. So basically what we're gonna do here is there is a clip on this end, there's an elbow on this end, so there's no need for me really to pull that pipe out of there, when I can just press the blue on the end of the cartridge and pull the whole thing out, okay? Swing around, same on this end, on the collar, pull it out. And there's that cartridge coming out. That's number 2, it's full of chemical, chlorine, it's going in the bin, we don't need it. This is the one we want, number 4. So we're just gonna pull number 4 out. I'm gonna sit him over here into position 2. Okay. Push our 2 ends back in. Grab our new cartridge. Now this cartridge here has come and it's already got the bends on it. So we're not actually going to need these bends here, okay? So I am going to pull them off. And this is our new carbon cartridge. Push them into position. Water's flowing out of the membrane into the carbon. Just have them, just spin them a little bit as you need, just so the pipes are nice and rounded. We don't want any V shapes or any kinks, okay? Same here on this end here. He's in there as well, okay? Okay, two old ones going in the bin, rubbish, don't need them anymore, okay? At this point of time, we'll just get all our red clips and you can go back and just slot the red clips into the collar. So sometimes you just grab the little white little pipe and you might pull it out a little bit just to pull the collar out, just so as you can get that red clip and clip it in there nicely under the collar. Okay, they go in pretty easy. But they are fiddly, no doubt about it. So we just take our time, pull out that collar, make sure the red clip goes in, spin the red clip around. A quick note on these red clips is you don't have to use them, okay? These aren't a pressure system, and even if you haven't got a red clip on, they're never gonna leak or come apart, all right? They're sturdy and solid as, and you'll never have any worries with them. But we do use the red clips, and you're more than welcome to put them back on. But if you lose one, it's not the end of the world, and it'll operate fine without one. No worries at all. So there's been six connections that we've just changed there in total. It's all sitting nicely in place. I don't pull these clips off. I leave them in place, and it's just much easier to change the cartridges over. All right, that's basically changed and there's nothing to worry about. Normally with a carbon cartridge, when it's new, you need to flush it, okay? Now remember, we've moved the cartridge from position four, the carbon from four into two. And what that means is we don't need to flush it because it's been flushed for the last year. This new cartridge in position four, it will have carbon fines come out of it. So what we're gonna do in a minute is we'll connect it up to the water, we'll turn it on, and we'll let the water flow out of the filter for a minute, because what's gonna happen is all black carbon fines are gonna come out. If you've got an alkalizer sitting on top, etc., you don't wanna pump the black carbon into the alkalizer, so just run it to waste, a couple of liters out, the water might be dark to start with, it's not always, just give the cartridges a quick little flush, and then we'll connect up our alkalizer and we'll be good to go, okay? So that is actually all back together now and there's nothing more to do. All right, we're gonna get our top and put it on. Once again, exactly the same thing. This is the gauge hose, by the way. We're gonna push that back into the gauge hose there. We'll get the rubber clip, red clip on there, okay. And basically we're just gonna gently tickle him over. Make sure the clips are inside. If it won't sit down properly, you've just got the cartridges rotated one way or the other, take the top off, just squash them together with your hands, check your pipes, make sure the cartridges are central, sit your top back on, you'll be good to go. This is the end here, where the water comes out and goes into this alkalizer, okay? So all you can do is pull the red clip out of the alkalizer at the top, insert, pull out the hose. When you push this into here and you turn it on, water will come out, could be dirty, bit of black carbon, so the water will come out. As soon as it's clean, turn it off, you can put it back through into your alkalizer, clip back on if you desire, and you're pretty much good to go. New cartridges, always like a little bit of a flush to get them up to speed, wet all the carbon, activate them. So before you connect onto your alkalizer here, you can just turn it on for 5 or 10 minutes and let it dribble and run away. They do take a long time to flush RO systems because they create water so slowly. So feel free to give it a quick flush. After 5 or 10 minutes, you can plug your hose back on here and you're pretty well good to go for another year. Thanks very much.